Hey everybody, it's Cameron Timmerman. ProRes RAW is now officially supporting DaVinci Resolve and stuff. Yes, you heard that right. You can now use ProRes RAW inside of DaVinci Resolve natively without having to do the whole CinemaDNG workflow or any other workaround to get ProRes RAW to work. And as you can see in here, I don't have any ProRes RAW footage myself. I had to download this from the internet from some random guy. But as you can see, this is in fact a Apple ProRes RAW clip, and I can modify what ISO I'm working in with whatever footage this was shot on. I can modify which log curve I'm using, and let's just switch it to Apple log 2, because that's another random thing that apparently Apple decided to announce today. You got Fujifilm F log 2, you've got Sony, you get the gist, basically. There's really, really exciting stuff, and this all came out with a new DaVinci Resolve 20.2 update, which also introduced a handful of other really great features, which I'm not really going to go over too much in this video, but I'll just show a couple of the highlights. We can now add rulers and guides to now add some text snapping or any other type of snapping to our actual viewer. There's some nice timeline quality of life improvements with trimming. There's some fusion updates with renderer 3D lighting. There's some other color improvements, but if you want a full detailed breakdown of all the new updates and stuff, just go watch this Team 2 Films video, because they're just absolute legends in their own right. So go watch them anyways and support them, because they're great. I just wanted to talk about this whole ProRes RAW situation, because when the 19.1.4 update came out and ProRes was now officially supported in Windows, there was a lot of speculation on, like, okay, is ProRes RAW going to be coming soon? And then when Apple announced today, as of the time of recording this, the iPhone 17 Pro is now going to include ProRes RAW in the Blackmagic camera app. Fellow YouTuber Michael Tobin correctly called out, like, hey, could we see ProRes RAW coming to DaVinci Resolve soon? Well, that was quick. Now, if you're wondering why ProRes RAW took so long to actually get to Resolve when we got it in Windows finally, and then Macs had it for the longest time, but you couldn't really do ProRes RAW at all, that basically had to do with Atomos, because they actually co-developed it with Apple. So the licensing agreement was a little bit different with that one, but now apparently they've worked it out, because now we have ProRes RAW across all three operating systems. So for Mac, Windows, and Linux. Super exciting. I just wanted to hop on here and talk about it because that was super cool. I don't normally do update videos, but apparently when there's a ProRes update, I do one. I don't know why that is. But anyways, that's it. That's all I got. I'm signing out. Oh yeah, check the description for audio, 70% off, all that good stuff. Cool.